something. You know, they can just stand there.
Oh, who's next? That's a rock.
Okay. So, you want to be more under the tail end of the halter.
Okay.
Let me show it to him. I'm going to toss it over his head. What you doing? What you doing? Grab it in your other hand. You grab the knot of the halter. You pull it off. And you tie it up. Okay. And we'll put Leroy on it, and you're supposed to leave. Remember how we talked about the leading thing?
He's like, no.
He's like, I leave when I want.
I mean, yeah. Oh, yes. Oh, he'll freak out on you too.
No sudden movements. You don't want to put two hands around him.
Okay.
So, what he doesn't know is it's everybody's instinct to do it. What are you doing?
Being ornery, now that you're explaining.
Because we have a tendency, what we want to do is hold a halter like this and try and hug the horse.
Okay.
Oh, he just does it.
But don't do it because you're too close to his face.
Okay.
And if he decides to object and not go backwards, he comes out the other place from he goes there.
Okay.
So if you stay out of his way, toss it over, grab it with the other hand, and then pull it around.
I know.
If he freaks out, you let go.
Boomer. Yeah, you gotta do a better toss. You gotta call it on his ear.
No wonder he's displeased.
So, don't put yourself in between him and the rail.
Okay.
So, you wanna move him out of there. And now you can try. And stand head on a little bit.
And what?
Stand head on and pet him.
Okay. I'm gonna come in and see how he deals with people.
Okay.
Don't kick me, bud. Good job.
That's your uncle.
But, you know, he's sort of weird when I come around the side. See how he doesn't want me over here?
Yes.
And he's not being bad about it, he's just
curious.
Yeah, and then he sort of shies away. Okay. So he's not real comfortable with me there. So you're not necessarily going to stand there, so you're going to get him used to you tossing him. Now he's a little better with me over here, so I can tie it on. But if you go to a place where he's already uncomfortable, so he's sort of looking at me, I've been here a few times. So, let's see this map. I don't want you to. Yeah, if this is the overreaction that we can get. You know, the trick is to recognize when he's uncomfortable and not. You have to know when to push and when not to push.
Okay.
So there's. And you go, and then sometimes I push him over. Not really pushing him, I'm just petting his face.
Okay.
They don't like that, man. Come off the wall again.
Good boy. Good boy.
So don't be, you know, the rope doesn't hurt him when you toss it over his neck like that. So you can give it a good toss and let it drop. Make sure you have the tail, the very end of the tail.
He's like, no. Sarah does that, you don't do that. Do I try it or no?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Hey.
Good job.
And now you can sort of step over there and tie it up. Now it gets easier after a while.
Yeah.
Where he will let you walk up and hug him and just tie it on that way. But you want to leave plenty of room so that if he panics, you can let go and be out of his way and he has a way to get away from you.
Okay.
And if you're trying to, you know, hug your horse like this,
getting a little leery, what are you doing?
I'm not gonna put my arm over there. But see now it makes you uncomfortable.
Yeah.
And where people make their mistakes is they go, they see he's uncomfortable and say, whoa. And it doesn't make sense. This horse is fucked up. This one isn't wild. Anyway, a normal wild mustang will just freak out and run away. And they're allowed to do that or they'll bite you.
Okay.
Yeah.
Has he even attempted?
He gives me this look, watch. You can see it where your ear goes and your left, that one right there. So you want to be careful when you see that. And don't push too hard.
I'm watching.
You can see the look where he's like, don't do anything weird, because you've done some weird shit. Because he doesn't want me to pin him all the way back. See, now he's getting anxious again. So I'm gonna come back here. And if you look for those really subtle signs, you'll never push him to the point where he needs to defend himself.
Okay.
And he knows you're listening to him. Because he's talking to you. And he's like, you know, when he follows me around, he's talking to you. He likes me to really be here.
Oh, no.
I like your teeth.